The James Webb Telescope, sometimes called JWST or Webb, is a joint project of NASA, the European Space Agency, ESA, and the Canadian Space Agency, CSA. It's an infrared observatory which can also operate in the optical range of the electromagnetic spectrum to a limited extent. Webb will have a 6.5-meter mirror and a sun shield with the size of a tennis court, making it the largest infrared telescope ever. It's the successor of the very successful Hubble Space Telescope, but with a primary mirror over 6 times bigger in area than Hubble's and 100 times more powerful. With this telescope, it should be possible to observe the first galaxies that have formed, and also to look through dust clouds in the Milky Way to observe planetary systems as they evolve. Since there is currently no rocket, only SpaceX's Starship would be able to do this, that could launch the Webb into space, the telescope is folded up at launch and will only unfold to its full size in orbit. The orbit of the telescope will be about 1.5 million kilometers from Earth, at the second Lagrange point, where the gravitational forces of the Sun and the Earth cancel each other out. The telescope needs 3 months to reach the selected point. One drawback, however, is that unlike the Hubble, service missions will be difficult to perform. Once the observatory is operational in space, the light from distant stars and galaxies are the first to hit the primary mirror, which then reflects them in a focused beam to the secondary mirror with a diameter of 0.74 meters. From there, the beam is then directed through the hole in the primary mirror structure into the tertiary and fine mirrors for fine deflection, before finally reaching the 4 science instruments located behind the primary mirror. Further, like any infrared telescope, Webb will only have an operating temperature below 50K, and some instruments will need to be cooled down even further. The main mirror of Webb does not consist of a single mirror, but 18 hexagonal, extremely light beryllium segments. At 625 kilograms, the mirror weighs only half as much as the Hubble's primary mirror, which is made of solid glass. Even though the beryllium segments are a clear technical advance, not all researchers were initially convinced by the idea, as it was feared that the main mirror would change slightly due to the forces occurring during the launch of the rocket. That's why technology demonstrations were carried out in advance, to show that the main mirror of Webb would survive the launch phase undamaged, and also to rule out any risk from micrometeorites. It will be able to directly image planets the size of Jupiter in our neighborhood, and it can also detect even smaller planets, provided they're very young and still glowing from the formation phase. Therefore, the telescope also has coronagraphic properties to block out the light of a star. Furthermore, Webb will tell us more about the atmospheres of extrasolar planets, and perhaps even find the building blocks of life elsewhere in the universe. The telescope is named after the former NASA administrator James Webb, who led the American Space Agency at the beginning of the Apollo project. But unfortunately, the history of this telescope is marked by launch delays. Originally, the development began in 1996 with a budget of $500 million, and the launch was initially planned for 2007. But various technical problems and a major redesign in 2005 prevented this. The next launch date is October 31st, 2021. Then, the telescope, with a total mass of 6,200 kilograms, will launch from French Guiana with a European Ariane 5 rocket. Because of this, the cost of the telescope has risen over the years to $10 billion. The mission lifetime is 5 to 10 years, and the prime contractor is Northrop Grumman, whereas Ball Aerospace and Technologies is responsible for the optical system. Thank you for your attention. If you like this video, check out our other videos about other space telescopes.